guys, so in today's video I'll be taking part in Nick Steen's Period Talk Challenge, which means I'll be talking all about periods. So I feel like it's really important for girls to be able to talk about periods and menstrual hygiene openly, because at the end of the day it's something really natural and really normal. And for some reason society likes to make us feel like it's gross, like it's nasty, like it's something we should be ashamed of and we should hide away, when at the end of the day it's literally as normal as a sneeze. There's so many young girls out there who feel embarrassed and ashamed about talking about periods when really you shouldn't. I feel like if there's questions you want to ask, you should be allowed to ask those questions without someone looking at you all funny. Like, at the end of the day you need to know this information. Also, I feel like there's a lot of girls who only learn about periods when they get their period, which really sometimes isn't that helpful. Sometimes it's kind of okay and you can kind of just swim through it, but sometimes it can be a shock when you first get your period. And honestly, just talking about your period when you first get your period and then sort of staying hush about it for the rest of your life really just isn't helpful to people. Hopefully by talking about this topic with you guys openly, we'll be able to have like a nice open discussion about this, you know, like a nice little supportive place for people to talk about these kind of things. And you know, if there's someone out there who's watching this video and they don't like talking about periods openly and they think it's gross and nasty, hopefully this video will change your mind. You know, stay to the end, listen to what I gotta say, and then see if it changes your mind. And if there's any girls out there who feel ashamed when it comes to this topic, hopefully this video will be able to give you a little bit of confidence and a little bit of a boost, because honestly honey, like I said in the beginning of the video and like I will continue to say throughout the whole video, periods are completely natural and normal. Literally, they're just like a sneeze honey, just like a sneeze. So I thought today I'd tell you guys about my first period. It's not super exciting, but I guess it's like kind of funny. So I had my first period around the age of 10 to 13. Honestly, I can't remember exactly how old I was, but basically I remember when I had my period and I told my mom, she was just like, whoa, you're actually really young to have a period. So it was somewhere around that mark, can't exactly remember. So picture mini me sitting at the dentist's office waiting to get my first ever filling. I was super nervous, and honestly, your girl just ate too many sweets and did not brush her teeth that well. It haunts me. I have so many fillings, it's unbelievable. But anyway, this is like irrelevant to the story. So I'm sitting there, I'm really nervous, my stomach's kind of hurting, I've got like butterflies in my stomach, and at one point I'm just like, you know what, I need to go pee so I can just relax, because I really don't want to just accidentally pee myself whilst he's injecting me or drilling my tooth. Wait, do they drill your tooth when they do a filling? I can't remember. It's been a while. I've been like kind of looking after my teeth instead. Anyway, I keep getting sidetracked by teeth. Anyway, so mini me walks up the stairs, goes to the toilet, you know, I do my business, I finish my business, I go to clean my business, when I notice some blood on the tissue. And at first I was just like, no, like Simon, no, no, I'm like, I don't believe myself. I'm just like, this can't be happening to me, like this is just too weird. So then I go to wipe again, and this time I see the blood clear as day on the tissue, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, what's happening to me? Am I dying? Like, wait, what? And I'm kind of freaking out, but I'm trying to hold myself together, because at the end of the day I'm in a dentist office toilet and there is nothing I can do from here. So I try and calm myself down, I grab a whole wad of tissue, I shove it in my underwear, and I waddle downstairs. And I literally mean waddle, because I have shoved so much tissue in my underwear I literally looks like I'm wearing a nappy. And keep in mind, I'm like 10 to 13 years old, so I probably look real stupid. So I waddle downstairs, and at this point like my eyes are like kind of like, you know, brimming with tears. You know when you're about to start crying and you got the tears welled up but you're not crying just yet? So I'm kind of like that. I go to my mom and I tell her what happened, and she's really supportive. She puts her arm around me and she's like, okay, it's all right, don't worry about it, we'll go home, we'll go in the car and we'll talk about it. And you know, I have no idea what's happening. I'm just like, okay then, I guess. So we're at the dentist's office. Kind of glad I didn't get my filling, but beside the point. So we leave the dentist, and as we're leaving, there's this old woman who we walk past, and she's like, oh sweetie, I know the dentist can be real scary. And literally on the inside, I was just like, woman, I am bleeding. I might die. Girl, do you even know what's happening to me right now? Obviously, I didn't say anything to her. I just walked past and I was just like, mm-hmm, real scary. Anyway, get in the car, get home. Mom gives me the whole 411 on period. She gives me a pass. She shows me how to use it. She said, this is what you do when you're on a period. And all is dandy and fine. And honestly, my period story isn't that scary in comparison to other people's, but I have had some really crazy, crazy scary period moments. Like literally, truly horrific. Like this one time I went ice skating and just, well, you know how that story will end. It wasn't pleasant, so I'm really glad my first period wasn't that horrific. However, it still does make me think, you know, if I did know about periods before, how would it go? I probably would have just gone to the bathroom, realized it was a period, go down to my mom, get a pad, stick one on, and then carry on with my day with my little filling. So yeah, I guess my point is that it's really important for people to talk about periods openly, because honestly, it's something just so normal. I know, literally, like the slogan of this video is gonna be so normal, so natural, but it's so dang true. So when I was in secondary school, one of my friends was raised by her dad and her brothers, and the first time she had her period, they freaked out. She thought she was dying, they thought she was dying, they called everybody, they called everyone, and then finally someone called them and was just like, chill, it's just a period, go to shops, pads, tampons, you're done. I know it sounds ridiculous to some of you guys, but trust me, there's people out there who don't know about periods because society has ashamed us so much that some people don't even talk about it. Some people don't even know it exists, which is just crazy because I feel like people need to be informed about this. Girls need to know that they're not disgusting, they're not shameful, they're not gross when they're on their period, they're just going through something normal. They should be taught what a period is before they even have a period because, I mean, trust me getting my information once I got my period was like, it was okay, but it wasn't the greatest, you know what I mean? And now in our household, things are slightly different. You know, my sister knows about periods. If she has any questions, she comes and asks me, she asks my mom. You know, it's completely fine and it's chill. She has that support. Even my brothers know about it, and I know some people find it weird to tell guys, but I think it's very normal, especially if you're living with girls. You need to know this kind of information. If you're an older brother and your younger sister suddenly starts having a period, you know, what you gonna do? You can't just freak out. You gotta be there for it. You gotta be like, you know what? It's chill. I'ma get you what you need. I'ma get you some chocolate and you're gonna be all fine. You know what I mean? And also, it just avoids some of those really awkward conversations you might have. I mean, I've had it. I'm sure you've all had it. Those days where, you know, your brother finally finds one of your pads, opens it up, and he's just like, why do you have a nappy? Do you wear nappies? Can you not pee properly? Why do you have a nappy? Are you a baby? Are you like an adult baby? And you have like 10 billion and one questions to answer, and just solve it by telling them the truth, right? And you know, some of these conversations don't always happen in private. I've had it happen to me in supermarkets. I've had it happen to me at a wedding where someone found my pad and was just like, oh my god, like, what's wrong with you? And also, as Muslims, during Ramadan, we fast for 30 days, and if you're a girl and you have your period, you don't have to fast during that little time period, which is great because, you know, you get to stuff your face and eat whatever you want. However, it's not so great when your brother spots you and he's just like, cheater! And then, you know, he's ringing siren bells telling everyone in your neighborhood how you broke your fast. So yeah, moral of my whole story and this whole thing is, please talk about this stuff openly. It's 100% normal and natural, which is like our slogan for the day. So when I first started my period, I started off with pads. They just seemed like the easiest thing, the first thing I was introduced to. You know, you stick them down, you slap them down, and then you're good to go. Sounds really easy, but honestly, it was not. I went through every pad under the sun. I mean all of them. Thick ones, thin ones, small ones, long ones, fat ones, super small ones, cushiony ones, ones that smell, ones that don't smell, sports ones that aren't sporty, like trust me. I went through all of them, and honestly, I hated it. Now honestly, pads aren't that expensive, but when you have to go through them like I did, or like any other person that's on a period, whew, it can add up. And honestly, my mom bought me a lot. And also, the other thing with pads is, even if it moves just a tiny little like millimeter to the right, that's it, you're gone, your clothes, finito. Remember earlier when I told you guys about my ice skating story? So basically, I went ice skating with a friend and I leaked. And not just a little leak, honey, a big leak. I leaked on the ice, I leaked on my clothes, I leaked in the bathroom, I leaked in the car, I leaked everywhere. And honestly, pads, just no matter how many times I changed them, no matter how frequent I changed them, no matter how many different styles I wore, it would always fail with me. And trust me, I went super hardcore. I'd wear like this really long thick one around like the front, like the nighttime ones, and then I wore like this long one around the back just to, you know, just make sure there's no spillages at the back, at the front, everywhere. I literally made like a pad nappy, and then I wore that with like really tight underwear so it would like stick on me and not move, but it still somehow did. And then I wore shorts, like, you know, those really tight cycling shorts that are like kind of thin so you can wear them under clothes. So I wore those, and then on top of that, I wore really tight jeans. So I was like locked and loaded, except for it was never enough, because no matter what I did, literally just the slightest wrong move and just the floodgates are open. And it ain't fabulous. So yeah, that really sucked. And then eventually I switched over to tampons. And originally I was really terrified of the whole idea of, you know, shoving something up there, leaving it for there for a while, and then ripping it out later. I was just not cool with the idea. But honestly, it got to a point where I was like, you know what? I either use a tampon or I free bleed. And I couldn't really free bleed, so I was like, tampon it is. And tampons weren't that bad. It felt a bit weird at first, but then I got used to it, and on top of that, I kind of saved some money. But the only problem was I had that weird discomfort. Like, the first 3 days of my period is usually really heavy, and when I used a tampon then, everything was fine. I couldn't feel it in me. It did its job. It was wonderful. However, after those 3 days, like the remaining 3 days or 4 days, it was not great. So like, whenever I put it in, it always felt like it was in wrong, and I always felt really, really uncomfortable, to the point where I could feel it sitting in there. Whenever I move, I could feel it, and it wasn't painful, it was just really uncomfortable, do you know what I mean? And at first I thought, okay, maybe I'm putting it in here wrong, like I must be doing something wrong, but literally I tried every single kind of way, and no matter what I do, it always still feel uncomfortable. So I don't know if I'm just weird, or just like, if this is like a tampon thing, I'm just really confused. So you know, I kind of went back to square one, where I just felt really uncomfortable. And honestly, like I said before, on a period, you don't want to feel that discomfort. I really hated it, and it's like, I just dreaded whenever my period came, because not only did I break out and feel terrible and bloat up, I just had the discomfort. which just like just made everything 10 times worse. But then I found my savior. So I do some googling and then I find out about period underwear and I'm just like, oh, okay, I like the sound of you. So Nixteen got in touch with me and that's how I found about them, and they're basically a company that creates like period proof underwear and it's amazing. Just, you know what, let me show you rather than just babbling about it. So these are the underwear. They're the Nixteen Ono Proof underwear and these come in a pack of two. They're super duper comfortable and they're super stretchy, and trust me, once you have these on, they do not move. They literally hug your body in the most perfect way and makes you look fabulous, feel fabulous, and honestly this stuff does not budge. You can dance, you can groove, you can shake it to whatever you want, and honestly honey, these will not move an inch. And they're also seamless, which is pretty awesome. That way you can wear them under dresses and skirts and you won't be able to see like the panty lines, and on top of that you can actually wear a skirt or a dress if you want. Like honestly, when I'm on my period I stay far far away from dresses and skirts, but with these I can, because I can dance around and I can be free but also protected. Anyway, so this is what the inner lining looks like. It's a thicker fabric but it's also super soft and super comfortable. It's like a hug for your cooch and it's beautiful. And this little thing actually absorbs 2 tampons worth of liquid, which is a lot of liquid. And it's anti-odor, which is pretty cool, because I know we've all been there, we're on our period, we're feeling super conscious, we get the spray, lift the leg up, and then, wait, let me try and get the leg up, can I? I'm not that stretchy. Anyway, leg up and spritz to spray everything, because you know we feel so conscious about it. I don't know about you guys, but I do that. Whenever I'm on my period, I spray like crazy, because I'm just like, honey. But yeah, I think my favorite thing about this underwear is the fact that it dries really quick. Like I mentioned to you guys earlier, I hate that sticky, moist feeling. And with these, they dry really quickly, so you don't have to worry about feeling that horrible, sticky, moist feeling. Just no wetness, just lovely, cushiony dryness. And then once you're done with them, you just chuck them in the wash, pop on your other pair, and you are good to go. Like, I only have a packet of two, but I think I might get another packet. That way, you know, I have more to sort of switch out. So yeah, if you guys like to check out Nixteen, I'll put that link on the screen right now, and also in the description bar below. It's nixteen.com. I'll also put their social media down below if you'd like to check that out too. And if you guys are interested in purchasing a pair, I do have a discount code, which will give you 15% off your first order, which is SIMA15 on the screen right now, and also in the description bar below. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully it was helpful for you guys. I hope no one out there is still feeling ashamed about periods, because honey, you do not need to. You are beautiful, and it is okay that you be, because it is normal and natural. If you guys like to follow me on social media, you can at SimonSmilesLike, but Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook, all that good stuff. But yeah guys, that brings it to the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, hopefully it was helpful for you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!